You might possibly know the Castro siblings, Julian and Joachim. However, they are the identical children of Maria Rosie Castro and Jesse Guzman. Joachim is a U.S. representative for the state of Texas and the older sibling, Julian, was appointed by Obama in 2014 as the Secretary of Housing and Urban Development. Both of the Castro siblings are far-left ideologues who play the Democrat identity legislative issues diversion like no others. Actually, their motivation for such far-leftism was their mom, who helped to establish the Laras Unida political movement, which displayed itself on different movements like the Black Muslims under Malcolm X and Saul Alinsky-like strategies of forceful and rough-in-your-face protesting. They never truly took off the ground, yet were well known for having expressed that they wanted to eliminate the gringo. As should be obvious, the Castro siblings think about leftist governmental issues, and when Julian was the HUD secretary under Obama, he utilized his identity politics as a principal point for the department. What he wasn't doing, be that as it may, was dealing with an extremely corrupt arm of the legislature. Current HUD Secretary Ben Carson has finished a current re-audit of the department from 2015 and 2016, and the outcomes are astonishing and, some could even state, criminal. Via Gateway Pundit, Obama's HUD received one of the worst audit results in U.S. history. The 2015 and 2016 fiscal year's HUD audit needed to be restated and reissued. The auditors were not able to initially perform the audit because there were too many material issues and the audit needed to be redone. The restated audit report shows the following. The total amounts of errors corrected in HUD's notes and consolidated financial statements were $516.4 billion and $3.4 billion, respectively. There were several other unresolved audit matters, which restricted our ability to obtain sufficient, appropriate evidence to express an opinion. These unresolved audit matters relate to, 1, the Office of General Counsel's refusal to sign the management representation letter, 2, HUD's improper use of cumulative and first-in, first-out budgetary accounting methods of disbursing community planning and development program funds, 3, the $4.2 billion in non-pooled loan assets from Ginny Mae's standalone financial statements that we could not audit due to inadequate support, 4, the improper accounting for certain HUD assets and liabilities, and, 5, material differences between HUD subledger and general ledger accounts. This audit report contains 11 material weaknesses, 7 significant deficiencies, and 5 instances of non-compliance with applicable laws and regulations. Auditors always have enough information to express an opinion, and so for the auditors not to be able to express an opinion shows the results were terrible. Material weaknesses are unheard of, and this audit resulted in 11 material weaknesses. Plus, the Office of General Counsel's refusal to sign the management representation letter is also appalling. The attorney's inability to sign the management letter is a clear indication that the HUD's books are in error. Obama appointed far-left Democrat Julian Castro to lead the agency in 2014. As can be seen, Secretary Castro was blameworthy of either being horribly incompetent in his position, or he was a standout amongst the most corrupt high-level government authorities in charge of an exceptionally corrupt association. It bears specify that the Castro siblings were likewise exceptionally restricted to the policies of Donald Trump and contradicted him with each fiber of their being, the point at which they could. The cash that Secretary Ben Carson has observed to be an error from those earlier years can never be recovered, and the citizens were by and by fleeced for all that they had, keeping in mind the end goal to bolster the leftist beast, yet that ought not to prevent him from proceeding to investigate the disparities. Like us on Facebook, H.T. The Gateway Pundit.